So I'm going to get into this module's assignment, and I'm going to show you some code, and this is already on Canvas for you, so I'm just going to kind of walk through it. But the challenge for this assignment is using what we've covered in class, the Pillow library in Python. I want you to create an image editing app with the following abilities. It should have at least two different filters that you can apply to images. It should have the ability to open a file from a list. It should show the results. And it should give the user the ability to save a file after they filter it so they can look at it later. So here's some things to try in terms of different filters. You could swap channels and merge them back. You could blur, shift, rotate, brighten, change contrast on the channel. Another thing that has an interesting impact is if you crop a channel and then you stretch it back to the original size, it has an interesting effect because of the way it pulls those pixels apart. And you could add text using image draw and image font. That's another thing you could do. So you could have like a meme creator or something like that if you can figure it out. So what I've done for you in terms of this assignment is I've put together a pretty good base code here, and I even did some commenting in there so you would understand what's going on. We imported OS, we imported several different things from Pillow. I did not do image font or image draw because I'm not using them currently, but if you want to use those, just import those also. The image directory, I have a directory inside my main PyCharm project called images. And then I have all my images in there. If you want to do something similar, cool. If not, you can put all your images in the same directory as your Python script by just reducing this to a dot. Okay, so one or the other. You either create the directory called images and put your images in there, or you reduce this to a dot. But you can see here, I've got my images directory, and that's just one of my directories in my Python project. But that's where I have all my images. It just makes it a little more organized. So I've got a few useful functions that I've already at least partially created for you. This one is complete. This one actually will take the base directory or whatever directory you give it, and it will return a list of the image files in that directory. So it, as an array. So you can use that as is, or you can change it up. I made a sample filter for you, and I commented each line so you can see what each line is doing. But you can start out by playing around and changing that filter up. Okay, so this is how you would build a filter function. I created a main menu function. Again, you can change any of these, but these are just some starting areas. And I included the press enter line here just because it's useful sometimes. So I created the structure of the app, and you can see here, I went ahead and gave you the code for opening a file from a list. Feel free to change it, feel free to take a look at it, but I'm using the enumerate function. It's very similar to what we've already done in class, so a lot of this should be familiar to you. If it's not, you can always ask me what something means, but this is pretty familiar stuff by now. And I'm actually here, I'm actually taking the files from the return files of the method or the function that creates a list of the files, and I'm taking those, putting them in an array, and then I'm enumerating that array, and then asking the user which number they want to open, and opening that image. So it'll actually return, or it will open a file into IMG file so that you can use it throughout the rest of the program. Okay, and then I showed you a great way to implement one of the filters. Okay, so this is the filtering function. Basically what it says is, if you haven't opened an image file, then you prompt the user to open the image file, otherwise run the filter on it. And so I left 3 and 4 blank for you to do. That is the other filter and the saving. And the rest of it is pretty intact here. So let me run this. We can take a look at what it looks like in the wild. Okay. So it tells you that there's no file open. If I want to open an image. Okay, so there is my directory of images. And if I want to open the strawberry image, there it is. So the file strawberry has been opened. Press enter to continue. Okay, so now it says file open strawberry.jpg. And if I want to apply the filter to it, filter has been applied. And there we go. So that's what the filter does. Yes?
Question for the picture. Is the program supposed to allow the user to access his own pictures, or do we give them like a list of pictures to choose from?
You're just going to put a bunch of pictures in the images directory. So create a file or a folder called images and just put about 5 different pictures in there so you can test it out. Yeah, and I would recommend getting some different pictures, because different pictures are going to give you different results. Oops. For example, if I do this and then I apply the filter to that picture, you know, you can try the different filters on different pictures. With this picture, it kind of gives it an old-timey look, like a Polaroid or something. But you can play around, and there's a whole lot you can do with these photos and the channels that can be interesting. So use your imagination. Remember, you can flip things over, you can rotate them, you can do all kinds of things. So just play around and see what you can come up with. I've had some really interesting filters come out of this class in the past, so I'm interested to see what you guys can come up with. But applying filter 2, saving image, those are for you to take care of or to figure out. Oops. Well, anyway, you get the idea. So that is assignment 16. Now keep in mind.